Praise the Lord. I'm Sister Divine Mosley, producer of the New Jerusalem Live podcast, and we would like to welcome you to the Sister to Sister Roundtable. Sister to Sister is designed to edify, enlighten, and encourage. Be blessed as you listen to today's podcast.
Praise the Lord.
This is New Jerusalem Live Sisters Roundtable Podcast, and I am Minister Pamela Harper, along with my beautiful sister,
Minister LaShawn McAllister.
And we thank God that you are here. We certainly welcome you to the New Jerusalem Live podcast being taped here at the New Jerusalem Live studios and produced by our very own Sister Divine Mosley. And we, of course, welcome you and to join us for our Sunday services. And that would be Sunday at 10 a.m. would be our Sunday school where adults and youth and children have an opportunity to engage in the Word of God, and our divine worship experience begins at 11:30 on Sundays. Also, you can check out the digital New Jerusalem at our website, newjerusalemlive.com. You can also search New Jerusalem Home of the Save on SoundCloud, Facebook, YouTube channel, where you would search for New Jerusalem Home of the Save. And you would want to subscribe to the New Jerusalem Home of the Save channel. We also, of course, are on the radio, praise God. New Jerusalem Live radio broadcast is WHAZ 1330 AM and 97.3 FM, as well as live streams on Sunday morning at 9 AM. Before we get started with our topic, a very timely topic, we certainly want to begin in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we do thank you, Lord, for this day. We thank you that you have blessed us in so many miraculous ways, more than we can even begin to count. And we ask, Lord, that even as we are on one accord here, we ask that you would just guide and lead us in this discussion, that it might be edifying to the body. In Jesus' name, amen.
And today's topic is proper preparation in a pandemic.
Amen. Woo, that's a title.
And we're going to start with this scripture, 2 Timothy 1 and 7. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind.
A sound mind. Amen. Praise God. The Bible lets us know that these things will come. And we all know, we may as well just name it, make it plain, that there's lots of talk about the coronavirus. And it is real. But the Lord also lets us know that he is real and that he sees us in our situations. He sees us and knows us by name, and that it's not his desire that we run to those who don't have answers necessarily, but run first to him. Praise God. And so we're very grateful to the Lord for just that reminder, because sometimes we can get caught up, amen, and watching the news or listening on the radio where there's just so much information, misinformation, but we can always go to the Bible. And the Bible reminds us that, again, these things will come, but it's not the Lord's desire that we operate in fear, but instead that we operate in faith. Praise God.
Amen. Amen. So even in these perilous times, we look to the hills for which cometh our help, because our help cometh from the Lord. Amen. We do use wisdom and, you know, discernment, because, right, you know, we want to be mindful that we need to, you know, wash our hands. Mm-hmm. For at least 20, you know, seconds, counting, if mm-hmm. that's helpful. Amen. You want to make sure that you cough into your arm. And if you use tissues to blow your nose, to throw them away, we have to be, you know, mindful.
That's right. Wise.
But we have to also pray. And amen. When you pray and you give it over to the Lord, he will answer prayer. He says for us to ask, seek, and knock. Amen. And when you ask, you have to trust and believe. So when we have a Savior who answers prayers, we won't get in a panic about what's going on right now because we know that our Savior lives, right? Amen. So also we have discernment, but we're still walking in faith, knowing that God is going to protect us.
That's right. Amen.
These things have to come, but he will protect us. For the word said that no weapon formed against us shall prosper.
Amen.
It may be formed.
That's right.
But it shall not prosper.
Amen. And even Minister McAllister, as you were reading the scripture from 2 Timothy and how the Bible reminds us that the Lord desires for us to walk in power that he's given us with the Holy Ghost, but also to operate from a perspective of a sound mind. And we know that when we get caught up and drown in fear and anxiety, it's hard to be consistent and continue to operate in a sound mind as the Lord has given us. And so, again, we have to continue to go back to his word and be reminded, because the world is going to tell us to be confused, to be scared, to be misled. But we don't have to receive that. But if we receive what the word has told, has given us, then we can walk in peace and in joy, even in the midst where people are going to be confounded. They're going to wonder, well, how can you have joy in the middle of all of this that's going on? And we can point them to Jesus. Praise God.
Amen. For the word says to be anxious for nothing, mm-hmm. with everything, prayer and supplication, and with thanksgiving, make your requests known unto the Lord. Amen. So we ask the Lord to cover our families, you know, mm-hmm. to protect us from this coronavirus. Mm-hmm. Because back in the days in the book of Exodus, in the 12th chapter, a little bit of the scenario is that, you know, there was a plague that was going to happen, and God was protecting his own. He said to his people to put the blood on the door. Mm-hmm. In Exodus 12 and the 13th chapter, it says, "And the blood shall be to you for a token upon the houses where you are. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you, and the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you when I smite the land of Egypt." So if you want to be safe in these perilous times, all you have to do is say, I plead the blood over my family, amen. Over the situation. Because mm-hmm. God's promises is yes and amen.
Amen.
So we believe God, and we're not going to be anxious in these perilous times. Amen. We're going to believe God, and we're going to trust him.
Amen.
We're going to have faith, because faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And it's just as you were saying, my dear sister, and we know that faith without works is dead.
Amen.
And so, yes, we have faith. We believe God. We know that there's nothing impossible when it comes to our God. And at the same time, he also wants us to operate in wisdom.
Amen.
Right? He has given us a measure of faith, and he's also given us knowledge and wisdom. And so some of those practical things he does want us to tend to, right? And being aware and being wise. But most importantly, he's concerned about our souls. Praise
Amen.
God. And again, in faith, that's where we're strongest, and that's where we can then begin to speak life unto others who don't have that faith. And so I, in some respects, consider this to be an opportunity, because in the middle of darkness, that's where the light can shine the brightest, where we can begin to share with others the source of our strength, the source of our peace, and that is in Jesus Christ alone. And I just wanted to read one of this, another scripture that is a good reminder to us. If we were to read in 1 Corinthians 15 and 58, it reads, "Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord." And so this, to me, as Paul was speaking, reminds us that whether situations come or they go, viruses come, viruses go, we're praying, but at the same time, we're not moving from this position of faith. And we want to continue to abound in the Lord, continue to demonstrate his will. We want to continue to be on the field, the mission field, praise God. Because again, our labor is not in vain. Whether there's a virus, or if there is a tornado, God forbid, or whatever the circumstances might be, the Lord still has a plan and a purpose for us. He has a calling, and he's called us to do his bidding. And so that's where we want to be, in that position of consistency and faith. Amen.
Amen. And everyone is talking, you know, about the coronavirus, and mm-hmm. I believe it's just a distraction. So we have to keep our minds and our hearts on God. Because this is a distraction. Everyone's worried, oh, this can happen. I don't want to get sick, and I'm worried about the person coughing next to me. But you just have to trust God. And most importantly, we know that in the end, it says in 2 Timothy 3:1, this know also that in the last days, perilous times shall come. So if you read your Bible, you know, as a Christian, you know that these, you won't, it won't be taken aback off of it because you know the Bible says these times will come. But what we really need to focus on instead of focus on the coronavirus is our own salvation. Because everyone, we're born to die. Everyone is going to die. Your body will go back to the dirt from which it came, but your soul is eternal. And where you spend eternity depends on if you're serving God or if you're serving mammon. So at the end of the day, what we want to do is think about our salvation. If you're lost, if you don't have a savior, you know, you can repent. Repent. Be baptized in Jesus' name, and you can receive the Holy Ghost. So when you do leave this earth, when your body goes back to the dirt, your soul can live in eternity with Jesus Christ. So we have to get our mind off the coronavirus and get our mind on our salvation. Because one day we're all going to have to take that walk and leave here.
That's true.
But it's only what we do for Christ that will last.
Amen. Amen. Beautiful, beautiful. And it's true. It's true whether people want to receive it or hear it or not, but it's true nevertheless. And again, we can sort of think of these situations as a wake-up call, right? Amen. That there are some times that situations come and they go where it reminds us of our humanity. It reminds us that we won't be here always, praise God. But we know that while we are here, this is the time for us to prepare for the everlasting. And the Bible lets us know that our soul is going to live on someplace, whether it be in heaven or hell. And that's just the truth of the matter. And as you were saying, Minister McAllister, this is the time for us to prepare. And so, you know, we're not desiring that these situations happen, right? We're not desiring that anyone gets sick or that they pass from coronavirus or anything else. But the Bible lets us know that our days are numbered. And we will not be here always. And so as saints, as those who are saved, again, we just want to be aware. We want to walk circumspectly, as Paul said, so that we can take advantage of these opportunities to remind people that there is salvation available. And that even in the middle of storms, peace is available and a measure of joy that's unspeakable. Praise God. And only the Lord can provide that kind of peace and that kind of shelter. And so this is the time. This is a wake-up call for some. And we pray that we don't continue to just walk through this life asleep. And many people say, be woke. And we want to be woke to salvation and the fact that salvation is available. Praise God.
Amen. Because I serve a God that heals the sick and raise the dead. You know, I serve an awesome God, you know. So I'm not no ways afraid of what's going on right now. I put my trust and my hope in God, you know, that he may direct my path and keep my mind stayed on him. See, in this situation, you can't look at the storm with your natural eye. You have to look at it with your spiritual eye, knowing that God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we can ever ask or even imagine. So in these perilous times, you just trust God. And if you just serve God and be obedient, because obedience is better than sacrifice.
That's it.
Then in the end, you will get to see Jesus. So no storm in life, no sickness, not will overtake you. If you believe and you trust in the Lord with all your heart.
Amen.
And lean not to your own understanding.
Amen. And the wonderful thing about our Lord is that he is trustworthy.
Yes, he is.
Oh, he loves us better than we love ourselves. And so he is concerned about our every concern. And I want to just speak a little bit to John 16:33, where Jesus said, these things I have spoken unto you, that in me ye might have peace. Peace, and I'll just say, you can't buy it. You can't sell it. There are many people who, if they could buy it, they'd get it off of eBay tomorrow. But eBay doesn't provide, doesn't sell peace. This kind of peace surpasses all understanding, and it's the peace of the Lord. And then it goes on to say in the scripture, in the world you shall have tribulation. Hello.
Amen.
This is one of those times where you have some of that tribulation. But the Lord goes on to say, be of good cheer. Why? It says, I have overcome the world. And so that's pretty amazing when you think about it, how the Lord has promised us that even in the middle of a storm, in the middle of tribulation, when there are more questions than answers, he still wants to give us a measure of peace, of cheer. And it's available. And that is just awesome, praise God, that the Lord can provide that to those who are his. And as I can tell everyone that Jesus is mine and I am his. And so, again, he's saying this peace is available to me. This peace is available to you. And I just think it's just a bona fide miracle. And I thank God for that. I thank God for that.
Yes, I thank him for his peace. I thank him for his understanding, the wisdom. I can say, I think back to Peter, you know, even when Peter, you know, he had a measure of faith. The Lord said we just have to have faith of a mustard seed. Mm-hmm. And a mustard seed is very small.
Right.
Just have faith of a mustard seed. And I think about back to Peter when he asked Jesus, can he walk to him on the water?
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus allowed him to walk to him on the water. Well, that was Peter had the faith and he had his mind stayed on Jesus. Mm-hmm. But then when he took his mind and eyes off of Jesus and put it on the storm, he started to sink.
Mm-hmm.
But we serve a God that he looked beyond our faults and he meet our need. Even when Peter was sinking, God still raised him up. So sometimes our faith might be small, but our faith can be increased if we continue to trust in the Lord. We have to trust in him. We have to believe. For me, myself, there's nothing but salvation in Jesus. Mm-hmm. I have nothing to look back to. He saved my soul. I thank him. I mean, he shed his blood. What a friend we have in Jesus.
What a friend.
What a friend. How many friends do you have that will lay down their life for you?
Ooh, glory to God.
He loved me when I couldn't even love myself.
Amen.
And because of this, I'm sold out to him.
Amen.
So I'm sold out to Jesus. I love him. I trust him no matter what happened. Mm-hmm. If I get sick, he can heal me. If he don't heal me, I'm still going to love him, whether he heal me here or on the other side of earth. But I'll put my trust in Jesus.
Amen. He's trustworthy.
Yes, he is.
He's trustworthy.
Yes,
praise God. And even as you were sharing about that mustard seed faith, and Matthew 17 and 20 just again reminds us, for verily I say unto you, if ye have faith as a grain of mustard seed, ye shall say unto this mountain, remove hence to yonder place, and it shall remove. And nothing shall be impossible unto you. Jesus said that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He spoke that thing and he meant it. And it was available to them and it's available to us. And even as I think about, you know, when I was a young girl and back in Indiana, and we'd always have a little garden, and you think about those seeds, and in particular that mustard seed being so tiny, so small. And I just thank my Lord, because he's not asking for a whole lot. He's not asking for, you know, an overflow from us, but he provides the overflow when we just extend our faith towards him. And so I thank God. I thank God for just that reminder. And we all know that we've gone through situations and circumstances, right? Whether it be health related or financial related or other forms of storms. Doesn't necessarily just have to be in the form of an epidemic or a pandemic. But if we look back over our lives and we think things over, we know that the Lord has brought us through each and every one of them. Praise God. We're here today because of the goodness of the Lord. And so even as we're in the midst of this situation with the chaos, with the coronavirus, many people are wondering, is this the end? Is this, apocalypse and all these other things that they're saying? Zombie apocalypse, some people have the nerve to say. But again, the Lord knows. And so no man knoweth the day that he will return, but it will be one day. And it goes back to what you were saying before, Minister McAllister, and us just being ready. That's our number one job. Some people use that phrase, you had one job, praise God. And I believe, sort of to put it in a, you know, kind of humorous way, the Lord would say that to us. You had one job, and that was to be ready, praise God. And so that is our aim. And not only us, but because we're concerned about other lives and other souls. We don't want to go to heaven by ourselves.
Oh, no.
Praise God. And so we want to share with others that salvation is available. Salvation is available. Now, praise God, as long as we have breath in our bodies and the blood is flowing, salvation is available. But there will be one day when it will be cut off. Amen. There'll be no more opportunity. And so again, this is the time, this is the day to be ready. Praise God.
Amen. Because Jesus is our shelter in the time of storm. He Amen. Is our shelter in the time of storm. Yes, and his word says we have to occupy until he comes.
Oh.
So every day we got to praise. That's every it. Day we have to ask for forgiveness. Amen. Every day we have to seek his face. Mm-hmm. Every day we have to praise and worship.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I read the scripture about Exodus, the 12th chapter and the 13th verse about putting the blood on the door.
Mm-hmm.
And that was in the Old Testament. But now you don't have to put the blood on the door. We don't have to slay the lamb anymore.
That's it.
Somebody's taking the place of the lamb, and that's Jesus, the great I am. Amen. So all you have to do is repent. You don't have to tear the veil. He tore the veil.
Mm.
All you have to do is go before him and ask for his forgiveness. And he will forgive you, and he will throw all your sins in the sea of forgetfulness, not to bring them back up again. So we have to trust and we have to believe, even in perilous times, mm-hmm. he is still God.
Yes,
everything
is.
That we're going through, everything that we shall go through, mm-hmm. he has already did it.
Mm-hmm.
Anything you need, anything you go into, you can find the remedy in the Bible. Mm-hmm. Jesus has given us the instructions, basis instructions before leaving this earth.
Mm-hmm.
And we thank the Lord for that.
Amen. Amen. And like you were saying, he has provided a remedy.
Amen.
He has provided us with a way out, a way of escape. Praise God. And like you said, it begins with repentance,
mm-hmm.
being godly sorry, desiring the ways of the Lord and less of our ways. And so he's just laid out the whole plan for salvation. And all we have to do is just enter in. Praise God. And so we know from the Bible, it lets us know that it begins with repentance. Praise God. And it continues in reading his word and accepting him as our Lord and our Savior. Baptism and then the Holy Ghost. The baptism by fire, in addition to water, is available that we can be a new creation in him.
Amen.
Praise God. And along with that new creation and along with that Holy Ghost brings about some tools that we have available to us that we can live a life that pleases him. Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God. God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is
Whether
good.
Whether there's a coronavirus or any other situation mm-hmm. that the news or anyone else is talking about, the Bible lets us know that these things do come, they do go, but nevertheless, we want to keep our eyes on Jesus. Praise God.
Amen.
So we thank God again for this time that we've had together, this time to just sit down and discuss the word of God and be reminded that he is our shield, he's our buckler. And we want to invite you all out to New Jerusalem, home of the saved, at 160 Sheridan Avenue in Albany, where the pastor is Dr. Timothy L. Harper. Our services on Sunday are 9 a.m., our weekly radio broadcast on 97.3 FM, praise God. And then 10 a.m. is our youth Sunday school, as well as our adult Sunday school. And then our divine worship experience begins at 11:30 a.m. And then throughout the week, we know that on Tuesdays at 6 p.m. is prayer and innovative programming. Wednesday, 6 a.m. is sunrise prayer. And then Thursday, 7 p.m. is our Bible study. We welcome you out to New Jerusalem, home of the saved, where the Spirit of the Lord is in charge. And we are free to worship the Lord and commune with one another. And we thank God for this opportunity that we've had with you New Jerusalem Live Sisters Roundtable Podcast. Praise God. You want to close us out? Praise God. Any closing comments?
I just want to thank God for this opportunity for we be able to freely speak about what's going on, and that even though we're, you know, it's a pandemic going on right now, we as Christians, we trust in the Lord, we believe in the Lord, we ask, we seek, we knock, and mm-hmm. God will answer prayers. Just make sure that when you're praying that you ask God that it be His will and not your will, that you can line up with the Word of God.
Amen.
Because His word is yea and amen. And His desire is for us to have a good expected end.
Amen.
So if you trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding, watch Him do a new thing in you. Amen. To God be the glory.
To God be the glory. To God be the glory. And so we just want to close out in prayer. Again, so very grateful for this time together, this time with my dear sisters, and just speaking the truth as the Lord has given it to us. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord God, we again thank You, Lord Jesus, for being so good. Oh God, You're so faithful. Lord, You're so consistent, oh God, and You allow us to be consistent. You allow us to be unmovable, oh God, and we thank You, Lord Jesus, that You have spoken, Lord God, that You've let us know that we will never be without You, Lord God, and that You'll never leave us, oh God, and we're grateful unto You, Lord Jesus. Please continue to bless those of us that are living and breathing, and we ask, Lord God, that those who are under the sound of our voice, that You would allow this word to penetrate their heart, oh God. Remind them of Your love for them, Lord. Draw them even closer unto You, Lord God. And we do thank You, Lord, that Your will be accomplished. In the name of Jesus,
amen. So we invite you, if you don't have a church home, to join us at New Jerusalem, Home of the Saved Church at 160 Sheridan Ave in Albany, New York. Come where the table is spread and the feast of the Lord is going on.
May God bless you.
We thank the Lord and we thank you for joining us for the New Jerusalem Live Sister to Sister podcast. We pray you are blessed and edified. You can reach us via email at newjerusalemlive@gmail.com. Check out our website at newjerusalemlive.com. Also, our Sunday worship experience begins at 11:30 a.m. God bless and keep you, of you until next time. Walk because of you. This podcast was pre-recorded. Because of the laws of social distancing, we ask that you view our services online. Sunday school begins at 10 a.m., followed by our divine worship experience. Thursday evening, Bible teaching, 7 p.m. Search New Jerusalem Home to Save Church via Facebook Live and YouTube Live. We thank you for listening to our podcast on today, and we pray for you as you pray for us. And we urge you all to continue to be safe and follow all necessary precautions. For more information, please visit our website at www.newjerusalemhomeofthesavedchurch or email us at newjerusalemlive@gmail.com. Again, we thank you for listening and we pray that God continues to bless us all. In Jesus' name, God bless you.